Okay, what's going on, guys? I'm gonna be talking about Ariana Grande's new music video. So let's get into this. So first things first, here you can see how like the city and everything. There's like tons of like everything's upside down. You can see the city going up and the city going down. So that's like the as above, so below. The two worlds coming together, heaven and earth, the red pill and the blue pill, the negative, you know. And there you can see like the black cube with the stairs connecting all the way right there, all the way. And then here you see her fall, falls off of the building there. You know, it represents like the fall when everybody falls. Because of sin and everything, and that's what's gonna happen to her if she doesn't repent. This shows that she's living on edge. And then here you see her in, you see the multiple personalities, which are the demon possessions that come over them, that take control of their life, that put them through torture. The diamond, it's like the diamond, the different sides of the diamond. Because they like the diamond and putting the using demon power in the diamonds and stuff. This represents like a maybe like a ritual or something, but the MK Ultra, you know, the different just like before. It's like the different types of her. She changes a lot, and this just shows right here. You know, she's gotta become the bad girl and not always be the same. Not always. Just like in Camila Cabello's video, she'll never be the same. She's gotta switch. Every year or whatever, it's gotta go with the certain arrows. So there you go right there. And then there you can see how it says God is a woman, which he isn't. You know, it's all about the, that's what the Illuminati push, the feminism, that girls are better than us or whatever, all that, you know. We're supposed to be equal, you know, and man of the house and stuff. Man is supposed to be man of the house. You can see how she's dancing on the black cube and everybody else is just dancing on rectangles, just lines. So that shows that she's Satan owns, so. She lives on a different axis than us. She's doing spiritual practices and all kinds of stuff. They're scattering her soul and they're using it and stuff in hell and stuff, and she's not like everybody else in the world right here is what this shows. She's still on the side right there. She's on the side and everybody else is just living a normal life or whatever. That's what that symbolizes. So the song's called No Tears Left to Cry. And then, so this came out this spring now. This is spring right now. And then last spring was Quit. I noticed that if you put Quit right next to No Tears Left to Cry, what that shows is she wants to quit, but she has no tears left to cry. She wants to cry, but she can't cry. It's that feeling of emptiness. You can't, you want to cry, but you don't really want to cry because you've already cried a lot. She wants to quit. She wants to run from the Illuminati. We live in a fallen world. This world is so jacked up. And then, so there's Quit right there. There's no tears left to cry. Boom, she wants to escape. She wants to escape so bad. But lots of these celebrities don't want to run to God. They just want to go right back to their normal life. You know, at home or whatever. So, they want to give it all up. They don't want to sing anymore. They're scared. They're scared of singing. I mean, they like singing, but it scares them a little bit now, so. She's showing you how she feels with her music. So you gotta get away from all this stuff. You have to find, you have to, stop being worldly and, like, you have to have a God. You have to find somebody. Otherwise, if you're in the middle, you just, You feel like you're missing something. That's why if you say this prayer and you come to God, then you'll feel lighter, you'll feel so much at peace, and you'll just feel so blessed. You'll go, you'll cry sometimes, and your life's just so much better when you are saved. So if you say this prayer right here, prayer of salvation, another prayer, repentance prayer. Oh Father God, I believe with all in my heart that Jesus died on the cross for my sake and has risen from the dead. Lord, I receive your word and I repent of my sins. I renounce the past, come into my heart. Lord Jesus, I receive my forgiveness. I receive the new birth, cleansed and washed in the word and in the precious blood of Jesus. Fill me with your spirit in Jesus' name. Amen. If you say that, you're saved. And you are broken from all the curses that sin and the demons have entered in through your life. Because everybody has demons and you need to get those out, and then your life will be so much better. I pray you guys send that. Anybody that's watching this, send that prayer. Pray in Jesus' name and repent. Amen. See you guys next time.